Welcome back to my channel, friends. This is Sonia here, and yes, what you can see is a stone. I have done decoupage work on a stone, and this was again from one of my wish list. Since long I wanted to do it, although Vanya has already done her tutorial, I am sharing the link down, do check that. And yes, I am so glad that I could make a tutorial also. So here our tutorial starts, but before that, do not forget to subscribe to my channel. And yes, I am sharing more pictures, the detailing pictures of this at the end, do check that. And let's get started. I'll start with cutting my tissue paper. So this is the beautiful decoupage tissue which I have been having since long, and this is just going to look perfect on my stone. And now I'm going to cut off the extra portion. I'm just going to just check on my stone that how much portion I need, and I'm going to trim it off accordingly. You can even use the technique of tearing off your decoupage tissue with a paintbrush in water. I have done that in many of my previous decoupage videos, do check that. But for this one, I think the cutting work also worked really well. Now I have to remove the tissues, but this was in really old paper, so removing the tissues was actually very easy. So both the plies actually came out really well, and I did not have to do anything. Now I need to prep up my base, and for any decoupage artwork, you need to make sure that you use the lighter shades on the background so that your decoupage tissue colors, the design, pop out really well. I have done couple of projects where I did try to use the darker shades, and trust me, it did not work for me, at least at all. So that's the reason now I try to use the lighter shades and mostly the white shade on my base. Now here I'm using my acrylic white color. You can even use your gesso. White gesso can be used easily for any of your prepping up base. Now I will be just doing two coat of paints back to back. I really don't need to let them dry because this stone is very easy, and it is anyways, the weather here in our city is really really hot now, so anyways it's getting dried up really fast. Now immediately I'm going to clean up my brush, and then I'm back with another paintbrush. And now by this time my base has dried out completely, and for this project, instead of using Mod Podge, I am going to use acrylic matte medium. And I saw in some of the with some of my friends using this, and I really wanted to try. And now with the paintbrush I'm going to apply this. Now if I compare this with the Mod Podge, this is really smooth. This gives a very thin layer, which makes your work really easy when it comes to handling your wrinkles or the bubbles or the tough edges. So now what I'm going to do is, with my paintbrush only, I am just going to spread it really well, and I'm going to make sure that I remove all the wrinkles from this project. It was a little task for me to remove the wrinkles of the edges because the stone has the curve at the ends, so I had to be really careful. And yes, I am going to add the medium a little more wherever it's required. You can even use your sponge daubers, you can use your plastic sheets to press and have a nice and clean wrinkle free decoupage paper. But for me, this one actually worked, as it's a very small project. The size of the stone must be approximately 4-4.5 inches, so it's not that big, so it was pretty easy for me to remove the wrinkles. Now if you see clearly, I am actually dabbing my brush on the wrinkle part so that it can actually be removed, and it pressed down completely if there is any bubbles or any wrinkles. Now but before doing this, you need to really make sure that you do not press your brush really hard, otherwise your decoupage tissues are going to get tear off, and definitely we don't want that on our project. You can always add on your Mod Podge or the medium, whatever you're using, to stick your papers on the sides in the remaining areas. This is not going to make any difference, but just make sure that you rub your brush really well so that you don't have much of wrinkles out there. I have posted few pictures at the end, do check that. If you check that, you will actually realize that I was able to remove all the bubbles by the end of this sticking work. It took me a little time, it just needs your little patience, and definitely you can do these runs. If you're a beginner, I always suggest to have your decoupage papers for your trial so that you can start with your decoupage tissues, because tissues are really thin. They take a little time for you to hands on. I am still trying, I'm still a learner, and I'm still experimenting a lot with my decoupage and mixed media artwork. Now you must be wondering how I'm removing the bubbles. Like I said, I'm just dabbing my brush, my fingers, and I'm going to use this. You can even use your sponge dauber. I have tried that a lot many times for my project and it actually worked well. But like I said, make sure you do not overdo the medium, you do not stick overdo of your Mod Podge. Now I need to let it dry, and once it dries out completely, I am going to use my colors. So here is a red and yellow color, and I am going to have this on my stone. Now I'm using my sponge dauber, and I'm going to make sure that I cover all the edges really, really, really well. The reason why I took the yellow and red color, because it is actually going to blend and match with the colors which is there on my decoupage tissue. And I also need to make sure that I cover up all the lines really well. This was actually a little difficult because this tissue has so many shades, the tinge of yellow, red, brown, orange. So I had to play around with the color so much so that I can cover it up. I had done my first coat, and then I realized I could actually see the edges, the lines. These are very, very thin lines. I really wanted to cover them up, so I am going to have one more layer of my yellow and red color, and I'm going to again blend it really well. Now to cover these lines, you need to make sure that you have your colors, the real acrylic colors. You do not add water to it, because otherwise it is going to look a little faded. You need to keep on experimenting a lot with your colors and decoupage tissues, and experiment on different mediums so that you know that how really you have to blend the color. Now for example, if this would have been any MDF base, blending color would have been much more easier. Although the stone base is really smooth, but still it took me time to do the blending work. Now once the front side is done, I am going to cover up the back side of my stone with the color. Now here is a mistake what I did. After using my first coloring on the front side, I cleaned my brush, and my brush was still a little wet when I started on the back side. So you can see how patchy this looks. The color is not coming out really well. So then I had to take another brush and start blending the color. And now if you see clearly, you can actually see now wherever I'm dabbing the colors, the colors are coming out really well. Rather than the earlier one, you can see the patchy work on the stone. So that's the reason, like I said, you really need to have your real acrylic color. Please do not add water to it unless until it's really dry and you are unable to work on it. So this is quite simple. Just keep these small little things and you can easily do your decoupage projects really, really well. Now blending color is fun. You can even do some stamping here. You can do some more decoupage on the backside also. You can do some glitter sticking work. Even they are also going to add some more little drama to your project. Now it's time to seal my project, and here I'm using my regular varnish. Yes, actually, ideally I should have used some other varnish, but with this particular varnish, my experience is really good. Even if I just wipe it up, my finished projects after some time with a damp cloth, nothing happens. So I am going to have this varnish on my artwork. So first I'm going to cover up the varnish on the front side and then on the back side. Now whenever you're doing a varnish, make sure you have 2-3 layers of varnish so that it lasts long. Your project does not change at all over the time, and yes, you can easily clean them up also. Before putting up the layers of varnish, you need to make sure that it dries out really well so that your varnish sticks to your project really, really well at the end of the day. With this, my project is done and I'm super happy. It's still a little hot because I have used my heat gun on this to dry it quickly. Yes, so yeah, I am so happy that I could do it and I hope you'll enjoy this tutorial. I'm listing all the supplies down in the description box. Do check that and sharing few more pictures at the end. And do not forget to subscribe to my channel and do hit like button if you like this video. Thank you so much for watching. Take care. Bye bye. Bye.